Pretty. Well, you are anyway.
Thank you.
We are live on Facebook.
Hello, Facebook world!
You scare me, mother.
Good evening, Catherine!
Hello! Today we are making mashed potatoes. We're making taters!
YouTube should be live. I'll be checking that.
Hello.
Can I be a taste tester for the mashed potatoes?
Yes, you may.
Because I like mashed potatoes.
Yay.
Well, with salt and butter on it.
Hi, Janice.
I don't really like it. Normal.
Hi, Catherine again.
Hello.
There's Heather.
When are we going to open
the packages?
Hey, Christy. Hey, Birdie.
Okay, guys, we're going to give just a couple more minutes, so I really messed up.
Actually, I didn't think. We forgot to mention it was daylight savings change. How many of the people are
I would hope they figured it out by now.
Well, but if they're in Finland or New Zealand or somewhere.
Do some places not change the time?
I don't think the whole rest of the world changes, but I'm not really sure.
We're really only screwballs in the world.
But hey, Dave in Georgia.
Call me when it's time to open the package.
Hi.
Okay, I will.
Big SWT Mama.
Okay, I will.
Little Glitter Queen.
I'm on live chat. There's an ad.
Oh, look, Jill Cooper's on.
Quick, block it. Oh,
I think that the time change confused them because there's a lot less people today.
Thank you, Stephanie, for ordering. I sent out a bunch of soap orders today. They're buying it as fast as I can make it. And then when I go and ruin $500 worth of soap, it doesn't help matters. I was not a happy camper. I was very unhappy. So if you missed it, here is Friday's cutting from Friday, Winter Hideaway.
I gave her the best idea ever.
And Christmas cranberry.
Should have announced.
Okay, what's your good idea?
With the soap, you know.
Huh?
So basically, on that, I thought, like, in the mold, when you're making all the different layers.
Oh, yes.
Do the little black lines, so mm-hmm. then when you cut it, it looks like little peepholes.
It does, yep. Yes, we're going to talk about it in just a minute.
Yay! Mrs. Now Parks. People are starting to join in. Okay. We forgot to tell you guys that daylight savings change.
All right, so today we're making mashed potatoes. And I'll tell you right now, I forgot to turn them on. I had planned on having them totally cooked for when the close show started, and we were running around like chickens with our heads chopped off, and I forgot.
Wendy says, I got my books today, guys. I've never been in awe of a cookbook to the point where I read it from front to back.
Yay, Wendy! We have people tell us that all the time. They open it and then they just sit down and read it all. So, good! Yay! I didn't know it would be reading material for everyone. All right, today we're kicking out a Dining on a Dime cookbook. Michael put the link in there for you.
Oh.
Should I go on the website and like tell everyone, hey, we're on one?
No.
Get on.
No. Well,
Dang cookbook. Okay.
Mashed potatoes, page 132. It's going to go with my roast on page 189 that I made for dinner.
Yum.
Let me show you.
Oops, I forgot.
Oops, just a second here. Ooh, oh dear. Okay. So, where'd happen
I'm
to my...
adding the mashed potato and other
okay.
link right here.
So there's my roast.
I was wondering what that delicious smell is when I came in. That was when I came in.
I was just being Miss Molly Homemaker. I was just Molly. There you go. That's my roast. Can you put the link for roast in there? I forgot to put it in there.
Yes, let me go grab it.
So that roast took me about 3 minutes to make. We cook it longer than it actually takes to make it. After we're done cooking, okay? And I was just gonna show you, just so you guys can see. Excuse me. I know, I do, should. Okay, so you can see here on my roast. Okay, this is very hot, so be careful. See how it just falls apart? I mean, it literally just falls apart.
Oh, so delicious. It's super yummy too.
See how it's just falling apart? I mean, I don't even have to do anything. So, if you want the best roast ever...
I just pasted the link in.
You
want
a bite?
Old Alabama gardener says, when you're old and retired, you can forget the clock.
Huh. Tell me what you think.
Mm. Oh, yum. You're going to tease me with that, and then we have to wait for the show to end to eat it.
Okay, the show's over, guys. We gotta go. No, just kidding.
Thank you, Laura, for loving our videos.
So, if you want the absolute best roast ever, use that recipe. And then I made a second one back here for our friends that I'm taking dinner over tonight. She is pregnant and not doing very well. Okay. All right.
You're going over there tonight?
Thought we would go over.
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. We are going over there tonight. I didn't know that. That's what I
mean. Okay.
Lots of thumbs ups. So, yay. Hi, Tasha. Tasha joined us, and Lisa joined us, and Robin.
Okay, so the first thing you have to do, of course, is peel your potatoes. Now, Mom used to lay a thing of newspaper down and peel her potatoes and then wrap it up and throw it in the trash. Because we didn't compost back then. That was before I started gardening and she didn't compost. Of course, then after we started composting, we would take the whole bag, or I mean the whole newspaper, peelings and everything, and throw it in the compost. Now, when I'm composting, I'll do that, but now I don't always throw it out in the compost. Because, like, my compost pile is just way overflowing to the top. So what I do is put on a Walmart sack, grocery sack, whatever sack, and peel them on that. And then I'll show you how super, super easy it is to throw it away. Yes.
Tara says it's her birthday and asks if we can sing to her.
Are you ready?
Yep.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Well, get over here if
come
you're
on, let's
sing.
All do it.
Hold on.
Oh, this is going to be a special treat.
Okay, get over here. No, you got to show your face.
Come over here.
Wait. Get over here. What?
Just go. I'll move the camera.
Okay.
They're going to see you,
Mom. Ready? Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Wow, you got the bonus deal.
It's smoking.
Good. That means it's cooking. Happy birthday. I hope you eat lots. Oh dear. Speaking of cake.
Thanks for coming and singing with us, guys. That was awesome. Dave was singing too, but he was behind there.
I hope you get lots of birthday cake. Nope, I was going to make a cake dictate to the Cunninghams and I forgot.
Uh-oh. It's Billy Graham's birthday too.
It's Billy Graham's birthday? Wow. How old is he? He's got to be...
This is 98.
I was going to say, he's got to be close to 99. Wow. Okay, so then cut off all the little nibbies that you missed. I don't know what you call them, in brown spots. Like that. Okay, and then look how easy that is. You just wrap and throw. Oops, and you dump your book all over the floor.
Oh,
okay.
Oh, oops. Some people got confused and they think it's your birthday.
No, it's not my birthday. My birthday's in July.
It was.
It's Tara's.
I think you pronounce it Tara, but it was one of the viewers has a birthday today, so we were singing for her.
Could be pronounced Tara, just as not cute.
So Tara's not cooking on her birthday.
Yeah. After I'm done cooking, okay? Okay, scooch out of the way, please.
Why do you have a...
Thank you. Okay,
well,
so...
Well, I think everyone's finally found us, now that daylight savings is...
coming back. Okay, so that's the easy way to peel and throw away with no mess. You don't have to use paper towels or anything like that. Now, to slice your potatoes... We only slice them lengthwise. Now this is an extra large potato, so I'm cutting it in just a few smaller pieces. But normally an average size potato, we just slice it in quarters. But since I have a jumbo thing here. So see, like this one, I would just slice in quarters probably, yes.
Oh, just everyone was chit-chatting about their confusion over your birthday versus Tara's birthday.
Oh, it's
Brooke
Tara's
says, LOL,
birthday.
Then happy late or early birthday, Tara.
Thank you. 5 months late. BJ?
Well, actually, maybe 7
before
months
before you
early.
Go anywhere, I want those things picked up in the garage.
Are you wearing shorts?
Yes, I'm wearing shorts.
Someone says, I see Tara is wearing shorts.
I know. It was like 80 here today or something.
In
I don't
Northern
know.
In Colorado.
I have never worn shorts this late in Colorado or Kansas ever.
Willow says ever. I should get you a present anyway.
I think you should too for yes. All the books I had to pack today. A suck-up gift.
The struggle is real.
Okay. So then we just quarter them. Oops, I missed one. Now, actually, these potatoes were extra big. And we probably don't really need this much mashed potatoes, but that's okay. We save them later for potato pancakes. Can you get the recipe for that?
Potato pancakes.
It's on Living on a Dime. I didn't realize I was going to say all this stuff. Sorry.
Yeah, I thought maybe I should get all the recipes for all potato stuff, so next time I'll be smarter. I didn't. Potato
so
pancakes.
Then, you put them on to boil. And I have some already started boiling here. And okay, so they have just a couple more minutes. So you want to boil them for about, well, it depends on how low to see. Stop showing your brother.
He's already in the shot.
I know.
So,
depending on where you're at in the country, you will need to boil them. Anywhere from 10 minutes at sea level all the way up to about 15 to 20 minutes at high altitude. So we're at high altitude, so it takes me about 15 minutes or so. If you missed, we're on Dining on a Dime, page 132, and I'm boiling my mashed potatoes. And then I'm gonna show you the super secret ingredient that makes our mashed potatoes. This is originally Mom's mashed potatoes, super secret ingredient.
Ooh.
So you guys can't tell anybody.
See, Amy said, hi, I was ready for you guys an hour ago. Forgot about your daylight savings. Yeah, I was thinking.
Sorry.
I don't think in your country, in Australia, they don't have it, right? You don't have it, right?
I don't even know why we have daylight savings. It's the most ridiculous thing. They used to do it for the farmers to give them more daylight to get their harvest in, but now it's just ridiculous.
A tradition.
That's just because we've always done it that way.
Velosa Phoenix is wondering, how do you stop the pot from boiling over? My pot always boils over, and the starch that leaches
mm-hmm.
from the potatoes is hard to clean off everything.
So what I do is I just watch my potatoes. That's the only trick I have. First of all, use a pot big enough. So I use a larger pot like this most of the time. You guys will probably see in 5 or so minutes, this one is going to boil over. It's just not big enough. And so one of the tricks is to leave it in a pot or cook it in a pot that's big enough. Also another tip, my dad's mom did all the time was they would peel all their potatoes and get them all cut up and put them in salt water and leave it out and leave it in the pot and go to church and then come home and turn on the pot while they were getting dinner ready, because they would always have big family dinners. And so they would do that all the time. So you want to tell them about your thing that you noticed today with your hands?
Oh, yeah.
So Jack has a problem. He wanted to tell you guys something that he thought was pretty cool.
Well, yeah, so I have a problem with my hands. Like, they get, they're pretty sensitive, so they get dry, close to the winter and also in the winter. So Mom gives me this, and guess what?
It's my lotion bar in a tube for him to carry to school.
She expected it. She expected it to last for like
2 or 3 hours.
But guess what?
What?
This morning when I put it on.
He put it on before school.
And then it was recess. And then I looked at my hands, it wasn't dry. Second recess, I looked at my hands, it wasn't dry. Lunch, it wasn't dry.
And awesome.
And I was even at partner classes. Wasn't dry.
Wow.
What?
And now it's not even, well, it's getting a little bit dry, but it's not.
Not too bad, huh?
Yeah, not too bad.
That's because
right
it's 4% now. Humidity here in Colorado.
Good, so it worked, huh?
Mm-hmm.
One more high five.
Really good.
So if you guys have dry hands, you might try my lotion bars because they really work well.
Jenny, well, one, someone else said there was an earthquake. I forgot what it was.
They're asking if we felt the earthquake.
Yeah, there was an earthquake somewhere in northern Colorado.
What?
And apparently it wasn't very much. But there was an earthquake in northern Colorado. Then also, Jenny Boyette says, I don't know how to say that, but... Do you have a problem with potatoes melting away?
Okay, so for the earthquakes, no, I did not feel an earthquake today, did you?
No, but I'm wondering if they heard of the one in Kansas, which Jill did hear.
Oh, so Mom had one yesterday in Kansas. She said it almost knocked her off her chair. It was shaking so bad, which is kind of freaky for Kansas. It's amazing how the Bible talks about in the end times you're going to hear about earthquakes and natural disasters, and here Kansas never has earthquakes, ever. Did we ever have an earthquake?
Nope.
And here Mom's had like 6 or 8 just in the last 3 or 4 years since we've been gone. It's crazy.
Two that I've heard of.
Yep, two that you've heard of.
Put that chopstick
and then on the... my mashed potatoes fading away. The thing that you have to do is not overcook them. So one time I had a radio host say, when I was talking about mashed potatoes, he said, well, my mashed potatoes turn to like this gluey, sticky, gloppy stuff. And I'm like, what in the world? I said, well, how long did you cook them? He said, 45 minutes.
Yeah, that would do it.
And they were in California. I was like, that's because you way overcooked them. The trick is you want them so that your knife or your fork just goes in really easy. And you probably noticed a couple of times I've come and checked. So, let's see. Okay, so this is perfect. Let me show you. Okay, so... how should I do this? This is very difficult to do this way.
You want me to help you do some? You want me to carry it over here?
Actually, well, just a second. Okay, so let me show you how to test first. So you should take a fork or a knife, and it should just slide right in. Just see how that went straight in like that? Just really super simple. There's no resistance at all. So I know that potato is done. So then you want to take and... drain off your water, okay, and this is always so much fun. All right, so I put my lid askew just a little bit. You might have to do a little dance while I'm doing this.
Dave?
Oh. Or Dave, can you show? Okay,
I need
so
something
now
better
Dave's
than that.
Gonna show.
Well, I can't really show you.
Well, as much as you can. Can you see how I'm holding the lid? Slightly ajar. Oh, it's kind of hard.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Yeah, I think they can see that. It's hard.
There.
The full screen up, but...
Oh, have mercy on my soul. Can you put the hot pad down?
Oh, yes, yes.
Okay, got it.
Okay, so... Now, if you don't have milk, you can leave a little bit of the potato water and... just add dry milk and mix some dry milk in with the potato water if you need to, and you can just use dry milk. Yes.
Christine asks, do you bring your water to a boil first before you add the potatoes?
I do not. I just throw it all in there and bring it to a boil and let go. If you want to bring it to a boil, you can. Okay, so then I'm going to pour in my milk. Now, you can use a potato masher. Mike's going to put a link up there of a regular old-fashioned potato masher. I do not have the strength nor the energy to do a potato masher. So, I use a beater. Here we go. Okay, so then add your salt.
Ooh, that looks like perfection. Did you put the secret ingredient in?
Not yet. I'm getting there.
I see.
It's a secret.
I'm waiting to find out what it is.
I have to wait in with tissue paste and put in your butter.
Oh, I think I might know what Grandma's secret to the gingerbread men are.
Maybe. All right, your secret ingredient. Can anybody guess what this is? Let's see if anybody can guess. Mom, you don't count. Don't say. See if anybody guesses.
Can I guess it?
Nope. You know what it is? Yep. The second one. Did anybody guess what it is?
Let me look and see.
Oh.
Sour cream, baking powder, lots of salt.
Sugar. It is sugar. Now you're going to say, sugar and mashed potatoes. I know I'm going to get all the comments. Try it. You will like it. It's not very much. It's just a little bit. But it just adds that little bit of extra zip that the potatoes need. And you will have everyone raving about your mashed potatoes. And we'll have our Mr. Taste Tester here come in just a minute and test them. Okay, so blend all that in. Luscious mashed potatoes. Taste tester, man.
Velocity Phoenix is like, you got it. I mean, you're right. I'm going to say sugar and mashed potatoes.
I know. Everyone says it's gross, but it's really, really super good. Okay. Put a blob of butter. Okay.
Yeah, I might not like it, but.
Why not?
Oh.
I might not like it.
Needs a little more salt.
A little more salt.
Oh, yum.
Oh,
man, your wife is a good cook.
Yay.
What about me?
Okay, there you go.
Oh, man.
Taste it and see what
you
think.
Oh, that reminds me of Thanksgiving.
Tastes pretty good.
Don't
joke. Super, super yummy.
Tastes like the same. It tastes like regular mashed potatoes, except it can sort of taste a little bit more sugar.
You can, huh? You can only taste the sugar now because you know what's in there.
Carrie asked if you ever save your potato
water. No, seriously, it can taste sugar.
For baking bread.
You know, I don't, but I should. I have a recipe for that. And so I have a recipe for potato flakes stir bread in here. And I'm going to make that in January. But
I have two
on page 88, we have potato flake starter bread, which is really good. So saving the water would probably be good for that. So, okay, Dave has two questions.
Okay, actually, one is really just a tip in air quotes. But, Dixie
tip in
girl,
air quotes.
Dixie girl says, not Dixie girl, someone else. Caroline says, never heard of sugar, yet we put sugar in our sweet potatoes. Makes sense. Simple Fool says, interesting, I'll be trying. I put a bit of sugar in my tomato soup. And also, Philosophy Mix wants to know if you put salt into the mix while you're doing the sugar.
Yes, I did put salt in there while I was mixing. So I put salt, butter, and sugar, and then we add more salt and butter in the end.
And then Cherry wants to know, is sugar listed in the book?
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Whoa, okay.
Now, one other thing, a couple of variations you can do on this. You can you go close that window? The neighbor dog's barking. You can add garlic cloves as you're cooking your potatoes. Like, as you're cooking them, you can add 6 or 8 garlic cloves. We like it really garlicky, so I'll put like 8 or 10 garlic cloves in.
Oh, I love it with garlic.
And cook it, and then just mash your garlic cloves with your potatoes, and you can have garlic mashed potatoes. Another thing that you can do is make loaded mashed potatoes and add sour cream and cheddar cheese and chives, green onions, anything like that you want to add, you can also do. All right.
Wow, lots and lots of questions.
Bring on the questions.
Okay, so.
I sent your order of soap today, Christine.
Stephanie says, sorry about your soap fail. I would buy laundry soap.
I am not exaggerating. I probably have enough laundry soap to last us 20 or 30 years from all my soap fails.
Lisa says, I'm waiting for my cookbook, so hopefully it's on the way. We did ship them all out, didn't we?
I shipped everything out today.
Katrina says, Tara, I'm in love with the soaps I received. The lotion bar is my new addiction. You hear me shouting from Texas.
Yay, thank you, Katrina.
I'm not sure if Jolene was talking to us, but she said I got your washcloths done.
Oh, yes, thank you. I can't wait to try them. That's one thing I love is fresh wash rags and dish towels. I don't know. I hate raggedy dish towels and wash rags. I know they get that way because you're using them every day, but I just like fresh dish towels and wash rags.
Oh, Sue Ann wanted to know why I slice the potatoes lengthwise. Did you already answer that?
Sue, because they cook quicker, but you're not having to cut them into little pieces, and it just saves time and energy.
Sorry, so
and Deborah said hello to my favorite YouTube couple. Thank you. Aww.
What about family?
Yeah. Family? And Janelle said, I didn't realize this was live. I thought I was watching the recording of the live feed. Hey from upstate New York.
I want to go up there and visit there. I just want to see all the trees.
Megan says, hello from Oklahoma. I wish I ever attempted any of these recipes. I'm sure my family would appreciate it. Go ahead and try it. That's why we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have trouble, ask us.
Philosophenix, this isn't a question, but they say every single, he or she, I don't know. But
she.
Yeah, she says, every single recipe I've made from Dining on a Dime has been a good hit. So I definitely trust you guys. If you say put sugar in mashed potatoes, I'll do it.
Yep, try it.
She also said it was 32 here in Sydney yesterday. That's 89 Fahrenheit, I think. Zoinks!
Ow! Okay.
Wow, that's pretty hot for spring.
No kidding.
The nifty thrifty bit says, so warm and sunny here, our watermelon vines that had not been pulled up are now blooming in Georgia. Wow.
Oh my. Yeah, I should have left all my flowers. I still have flowers in the front yard that are hanging on. Daisies, of all things.
And yeah. Evenie119 said you can never have too much compost. Compost all your peels in a BK garbage bag? What is, or a garbage bar?
I have no idea what that is.
And Maureen says worms help to compost pile lots. Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. When we were in Idaho, there was this long runway by our house, and whenever it would rain, the worms would come out. We'd go collect them all on our walk, and we'd bring like 300 of them home.
The thing is I have 3 compost piles already, and we're thinking about moving, and so I really don't want to add more compost because we're probably going to have to throw away the compost I have because most people don't appreciate compost the way I do.
Oh, hey. We should bring it to the new place.
I can see on the 5th day of moving, you're going to be wanting to shovel compost.
Can I tell them something?
Did I already say Mary Alice was asking?
Regular sugar. Regular granulated sugar, not powdered.
And Christine says, never heard about using sugar in mashed potatoes. I do that to my chili, though.
Yes. The thing is, guys, sugar... Oh! When you add sugar to savory dishes, it just adds that little oomph that makes it so good. And the opposite of true is if you add salt to sweet dishes, like if you salt your melons or if you just add a tiny bit of salt to a sweet dish, that helps bring out the flavor better. Pretty delish, huh?
But I was also going to say, these mashed potatoes are potatoes are so good that now I'm having a headache. They're so good that now I'm having a headache.
They're so good that they give you a headache.
Bursted your bubble there, made you, huh?
For those of you who are confused, because Melinda is asking, what time did we come on? We came on at 4:30 Mountain, but because of daylight savings, I think it confused a lot of people.
Yeah, sorry, guys.
Go ahead, Dave.
Ma'am and Akshi says, how much fragrance do you put in soap? My husband makes soap, and after it is cured, it doesn't have smell.
So fragrance oil lasts better than essential oil. Essential oil evaporates much quicker. And I put about a ounce per pound. No, wait a minute. Yeah, an ounce per pound of oils.
Okay, you're going to love it. Well, Annabelle says, I'm making Salisbury steak and mashed potatoes for dinner, so I'll try the sugar.
Yep, try it.
And Denise says, my poor sister goes to the in-laws and her mashed potatoes are horrible. Her kids thank God she makes the gravy. They buried the potatoes in it. Better flavor. Wish you would watch some of your videos. Thanks, Denise.
Oh, dear. Maybe we shouldn't have said your name, Denise, and you could have sent her the...
And Tanya says, I'll have to triple the recipe for Thanksgiving. We can never have too many mashed potatoes.
Yeah, we make mashed potato pancakes that really are good for after.
Oh, and Laura received the soap today. Thanks for the sample.
Yay, you're welcome.
JoJo says, I want to ask, do you know of an alternative to golden syrup? I desperately want to make flapjacks, a British snack.
Well, if I knew what golden syrup was, I would help you, but I don't know what that is. I'm sorry. Or if you can kind of tell me what it is. Maybe it's something that we make and I don't know.
Sorry. Phyllis asked if we're cooking a turkey for Thanksgiving.
Yeah, so we're cooking a lot of turkey. So I am doing how to cook a turkey on Wednesday.
This Wednesday?
Shall we all pray that the turkey will work out right now? Lord, please don't let our turkey end up on the floor like it did 3 years ago. Yes. Amen.
Was it 3 years ago already?
Yes. So 3 years ago, I cooked a turkey for Thanksgiving because my grandparents came over, and I've only cooked Thanksgiving dinner like twice in 20 years. And I proceeded to pull it out of the oven, and it had overflowed because my pan wasn't big enough. I don't have a turkey roasting pan. I need to buy one, but I'm just too cheap for Thanksgiving.
Lots of laughing faces.
And it was greasy, and it was just like one of those funny movies. I grabbed it, and I am not exaggerating. I grabbed it like this. So I was in the oven. I grabbed it like this, and it just kept sliding and just whoosh, right all over the floor, counter, everything. We'll show you a picture on Wednesday. But
hey, Mom. What's going on? So Cheryl says, how are you guys doing? Can I use red potatoes?
You can, although red potatoes aren't, they're a little more starchy, so they don't turn out quite as well as white, but you can. So Dave got a present today.
What?
And I looked, tried to find the email, and I couldn't find the email. It was, her last name is Sheeler. Sheeler. Okay, so come here, look what Dave got.
We should have looked her up.
And he was so happy. I did. I couldn't find it.
I'm off of moderating the comments, so.
So, these are nice flannel shirts. Thank you so much.
I should get just stick this through the camera and be like, hey, feel it.
Oh, it was, they are so nice. And look at this handsome dude. Mm-hmm, with his new haircut.
Wow.
Woo! Okay, try on this one.
Hey, girl.
Well, look at all those hearts going across the screen, Dave.
All the girls are going to be after you. Wanted to meet you at the twirly slide.
Oh, no. What if it's just this
funny? Like, heart.
Thank you so much.
Like, heart, you look good.
Yay! Thank you. Like, we got them one. We got them one. Flannel shirt at Walmart, and he's been wearing it since we bought it on Thursday.
Mom, watch this. Watch this again.
I cannot watch keep it. Track.
Okay, next question.
Can I play my drum? Mini drum?
Carrie said, oh, roasted garlic. Yum. Okay. Melinda wants to know what's for dinner.
So we're having roast and mashed potatoes.
Barbara was talking about bacon as a flavor for the potatoes. Yum, definitely.
Yes. I also will put bacon grease in place of butter in my potatoes, in my mashed potatoes, and that, oh, is so good.
Oh, I'm kind of behind on comments.
Oh, dear.
Okay. Let's see. Lori
is Robin on there? Did you see Robin?
Yes.
Okay. So we got a package from Robin today, too,
what?
And we haven't opened it yet. I mean, I sliced it open just so it'd be ready for the show, but we haven't looked in it yet. Should we do that now, or should we answer comments?
Oh, we could do a couple comments, but yes, I would
okay,
open it.
Okay, we'll do a couple comments.
Just because they're about to scroll off the screen. Okay. Carol asks, can you remelt soap into acne soap?
Oh my goodness, I'm having such a bad day.
Is that like from, from cartoons?
Yes, I probably could.
Oh my goodness, I'm having such a bad headache right now.
You are.
Carrie, does Mike ever not smile?
Yes, when I'm mad at him.
Yeah. So then I just go away so nobody sees me not smile. Maureen, how much active charcoal in the baby shampoo and where do you get that?
So active charcoal, you can just get the pills at Walmart or you can buy the bag of it at Amazon. I just got the pills. Because I just wanted to try it. It's super, super cheap. I think it was like $5 or something for a whole bunch. Yeah, go ahead.
We can open that if you want. There's a bunch more questions.
Okay,
but.
Okay. Well, what is happening? What is going on?
Coming in here.
Oh, okay. And I put about a tablespoon in an entire bottle of baby shampoo. So, you know, the pump bottles they have. And I'll do a post on it. Okay. Oh my goodness. This is huge. The hair thing. Yes. So look how nice and non-oily the hair is.
Unboxing.
Whoa. Okay, let's see. There we go. Hold on.
Oh, I see something delish.
Wait, are those
sugar
babies?
I've been craving this.
Oh my goodness.
I'm taking it. She said
she knows we don't like things pink. Oh, these are for me and the girls. Oh, how nice.
And she got me all the...
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
That's
oh, my goodness.
These ones were...
Cotton candy, yay.
She said these ones were, and these were different.
Ugh. Wow, it's like Christmas.
Wow. Well, I don't think they're all.
Thanks.
Are they
they're
all
not all
yours?
For you, Dave.
I think you could probably share some.
She said on the comments that
whoa,
she needs six.
Blue look raspberry, at all these. Banana.
Whoa. Look That's at this. Me. Oh my goodness. So she says this is our Christmas box.
And more jelly babies.
I think these are for you.
I think at that
many
the other day I was thinking, I'm so
have.
Sad I ate that
I think
whole
you
bag.
Have a lot.
It's all gone.
Oh, man.
Bubblegum.
Thank you, Robin.
Nice, Robin.
She got bubblegum and banana and blue raspberry and
more
other stuff.
More socks for the girls at
Thank
our
Thank you.
Love fluffy socks.
This
Thank
thing was
you.
Mom, your mashed potatoes are.
Okay, so should we try a little bite? Oh, dear. Careful. Oh, dear.
Got it.
Oh, my. So this is perfect.
Robin, send me some more. Okay.
How many can I have of these?
We can have a couple. Oh, this is lemon. I've never had lemon. That is really good.
Me either.
Lemon? I don't like lemon.
Oh, man, that is good.
Here you.
They can't try.
Never ever heard of lemon.
Lemon.
Thank you, Robin.
Whoa.
Wow. Banana, blue raspberry.
Robin, I need you to make me more.
Tell Dave to share the cotton candy.
Too late. I already ate it all.
Man, I love getting stuff in the mail. It's like Christmas every day. Oh, how cute. They're little Christmas ornaments. Did you make these, Robin? Those are cute.
Oh, and Ellie would especially like the penguin. Oh,
look at the little reindeer and the dog. Oh, aren't those cute guys? So, we're decorating our tree next week. Oh, how cute, a little skating thing. So I will put these on our tree.
Maple. This is maple.
Barbara says mashed potato candy.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness.
Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
He knows you.
Oh, my goodness. I have never seen this before. Look what I got.
Wow, you're going to have to keep that in a special place.
Look at all the cute little guys.
Oh. Mom, can I have all of these?
And look at this pot holder. You can have, you guys can share, yeah. You can have those. Yeah, you guys can share.
I got these six, you got those.
You got to share with BJ and Ellie and Emily.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a little gnome pot. Oh, my goodness. Thank you. That is so nice of you.
That is wonderful.
And look,
I thought that's the one you were super excited about because I've never seen one of those before.
How cute!
Oh, that's really cool.
Look at his little pants. Isn't that cute? Oh my goodness. Thank you so much.
Is there anything else?
There's a card for BJ. What? Happy birthday! Wow, well, thank you, man. That was cool. Thank you so much. Oh, wow.
You're so awesome. Robin, just tell me hi on YouTube. I don't think she's on YouTube.
She's not? Oh, no, she's probably not on YouTube. The other day we took, remember our...
Oh, she's talking to somebody else. Sorry.
Remember our viewer, Jamie, that said I should bring the pie over to her as a housewarming gift because she lives not too far from us now? So Mike and I decided to surprise her, and we took the pie to her. So then when we did, she gave me this soap, and I haven't opened it yet because I wanted to open it.
Smells really good, though.
And our viewers are so loving. Oh, my goodness. Everyone likes us.
This is called Monkey Farts, and it smells so good. I was curious what it was. What? Isn't that cute with all the curls and everything? Who gets to
it
use it?
Smells so good. You.
Can I smell it?
I don't.
Can I smell it?
Never thought monkey farts would smell so good.
I know. Doesn't that smell good?
Where are the monkeys?
Well, it's not monkeys. It's just curly cues and stuff. Oh. Okay, let me check these potatoes. Okay, go ahead with the questions, dear.
Oh, thank goodness.
Sorry.
Let's see. Susan, Dave's hair is so shiny today. And Denise says, looking good, Dave. And so does Laura.
Thanks, everyone.
Melinda, that's what I just made. I think the cotton candy she means. Aisha, it's like Christmas.
Man, that was like Christmas.
Denise said, I'll have to try the baking grease and the potatoes. Sounds delicious.
It's really good.
Lorena, what part of Colorado? I'm in Englewood. We're just north of
Longmont.
Jolene says, do you have any ideas for greasy hair? My niece washed it and it's greasy minutes later.
Yes. So I just told our viewers today while I was doing... So my soap, I had a huge soap fail and then I couldn't make soap and because I didn't have my oil. But I was cutting this one and on that show I was talking about how Dave had really oily hair and we've been trying all kinds of shampoos. So last night, here, come over here. Last night we did baby shampoo and I put activated charcoal in it and look at this bouncing it. Oh. I'm sorry.
Smack his glasses
look at
right
this
off.
Bouncing and behaving hair. Oh man. It worked great. So try baby shampoo with activated charcoal. Did you bring it to me, Dave? Did you bring me the charcoal?
No, I just was going to bring my head
to use. Oh, the head. So, okay. Mom.
Oh, Kareem says she loves cream cheese in her potatoes.
Yes, cream cheese would be really good.
Carrie says, Tara, I'm so amazed at how well you focus with all the interruptions.
Well, I don't focus very well, let me tell you. I pass out when I'm done with the show.
Anne said, my mom used to make fried mashed potatoes. Oh, those are good.
Yes. So we have potato pancakes. Wherever my book went, potato pancakes, and that is the, I think it's similar recipe. What did you want to say?
You know what's the best part about getting the...
Can I try a little bit?
You know what's the best part about getting the cotton candy?
Huh.
I can build stuff with it.
You can build stuff with cotton candy?
No, with the...
Oh, you love the containers. Jack loves building things. Thank you so much. Wow, you had that one down quick. Okay, don't eat anymore because we're going to eat dinner in just a minute. Thank you, Robin. That was so nice of you. By the way, I shipped your soap today.
Let's see. Oh, oops. I had some
Hey, it's a trade-off. You shipped the soap and she shipped all the other stuff to us.
Where was that one? Kareem had asked something. If you'd heard of... where was that? Oh, Lori says, have you tried the white sweet potatoes? Awesome. Never heard of those.
I have not. I didn't even know there was such a thing.
Mom.
And Catherine says, they're expecting frost in Georgia.
Oh. We've had a frost, but not a freeze yet.
And Kelly said, 65 and sunny in upstate New York today, but wet snow in the forecast for Saturday.
Oh,
that's a big change.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Jolene said, what oils are the best to make soap?
So my recipe is olive oil, let's see, olive oil, coconut oil, castor oil, avocado oil, and palm oil or lard, whichever you prefer. And I like those the best for me personally. You can experiment with tons of different oils and make very, very good soaps.
Thank you so much, Robin. By the way, I've already finished two of them. Are empty already.
Okay, so let's see. Carrie, I made my first crockpot potatoes. They were pretty good.
Oh, yum.
And Christina wants to know, is this actually your kitchen at home?
Yes, it actually is.
Annabelle said, daylight savings is so you can put the kids to bed earlier, LOL.
Amen. Thank you. We are one. Feel it.
Then the kids wake up early.
I say the sooner you get them to bed, the better.
And Robin said, I use a little bit of baking powder to make my potatoes fluffy.
Oh, that's a good idea. I should try that. I've never tried that.
And, sorry, I was having a problem over here I needed to deal with, buddy. Philosophy Phoenix, did Mike used to sing in a choir? His harmony singing is very good. Wow, thank you. Well, I do now, but only just started. So.
He does now, but he only goes to practice like once a month.
Well, that's because we had a birthday party and a kids' choir concert.
And but, then we left for a mini vacation, which I think we need to go again.
I've only been there for two songs, though.
Hey, I need another mini vacation.
Can you guys just let me stay at Robin's house for like an entire like week so then we can just keep making content?
So we thought of a good show, guys. So we just showed up at Jamie's house, the one who gave us the soap. And we took her the pie. We thought, you know, we should do a show where you guys send us your name and your address. And we'll just start touring the country. And we'll just show up at somebody's house sometime.
Yeah. The thing is, at the moment, it would mostly be in Colorado.
Well, that's true, because we can't afford to go anywhere else. But, you know, maybe someday somebody will notice us and we could, you know.
Well, we have, yeah. We have had family get noticed so far for being on the show. Shannon said, where do you get active charcoal?
Activated charcoal, you can buy it in pills at Walmart just in the supplement section, or you can get it on Amazon in big bags. I would start at Walmart and just peel. You can just pull the capsules apart. Start with that first and see if it works before you buy a big bag of it.
Let's see. Sorry, we still had some more over here. Robin said... she's talking about her mashed potatoes. She says, mine is a heart attack. I put a whole stick of butter and a half a cup of warm milk.
Yeah, normally I do put almost, not quite a whole stick, but I, pretty close. I agree with you. It's best with a lot of butter.
And Jolene, you might have answered this already, but Jolene asked if you need to use avocado oil making soap.
No, you do not have to. I just like it for the moisturizing properties. You could use grapeseed oil. You could just leave it out. You don't have to use it. You could use canola oil, shortening, lard, anything else, but you do not have to use it. It is difficult to find. I order mine online.
And Sheila said, Sheila says daylight savings is Ben Franklin's idea, a way to save candles. Somebody else had said it was something after World War II. So
I heard it was after World War II they did it to help farmers have more time for planting and harvesting. But maybe that was just a wives' tale. I don't know. That's what I'd always heard.
So while you were making the potatoes, Robin said, look at Tara's face. She looks so thrilled when she's whipping those potatoes.
I actually cooked something that didn't burn.
And Lori,
speaking of which,
Lori said, I'm a nurse and hoping your lotion bars will help my dry skin from washing my hands so much. Thanks for mentioning them.
I have two people who are family members that work in hospitals and they swear by it. So you might give it a try.
So I'll paste that in again so you guys can have that.
Also, you can buy them on my Etsy store. Michael put the link there. I do make and sell them if you don't want to bother buying all the stuff.
Uh-oh. Stella says, come visit Richmond, Virginia. And Carrie says, come to Traverse City, Michigan. In the summer, you can stay with us. And Phyllis was saying it's dark so fast there. Well, yeah, it wasn't.
The sun went down at 4:20 today.
Just because of the daylight savings change. But
yeah,
it is further north than some other places, though. Jolene says, time to make dinner. Love you. Oh, good night, my down earth family. Good night, Jolene.
Goodbye. Have a good night.
Carol says Ben Franklin thought of it, but it didn't come into being until World War II.
Oh, I see.
Let's see. Oh, more people saying that David's good looking.
Any girlfriend applications must come through mom first, and he cannot start dating at least for 3 more years.
This is Robin. No.
So I can even use a lid for making straight circles.
Very good. See, we use everything, don't we? You washed it out. He's already using his cotton candy thing.
Robin said, Mike, I know you do production, but are you a pastor too? I am not a pastor. Although, I have a lot of knowledge. A lot of Bible knowledge, so.
I keep telling you should do a Bible website, but.
Well, I kind of would like to.
Hey, Robin. I have a question for Robin. So, if you are hearing this, if you're still on Facebook, please respond to this. But do you want these back so that you can make some more for me? Mostly me.
She probably doesn't. It probably costs too much to ship them back, Dave.
Aw, man.
I know. You want a refill, huh? Well, maybe if we ever go visit her in Pennsylvania, she'll make you some.
Oh, I have a joke about Pennsylvania.
What?
So, where do pencils go go on a vacation?
Where?
Can I have them do it in the car?
Where do pencils go on vacation?
Where do pencils go?
Georgia.
On Washington.
Uh-uh.
Kansas.
Uh-uh. Colorado.
No, let's have the viewers guess in the comments.
I wonder, Dad, where do you think pencils go for
They go to Norway.
They go to Norway?
Yeah.
Why don't you tell us? Because we're gonna have to get off in just a minute.
Pennsylvania.
Oh, yes! I get it.
Colossal Phoenix says, "I would love for you to do a Bible study Q&A type show sometime."
Wow.
Ask Michael.
I might have to do that.
Uh-oh.
Wow. I was thinking of doing that. I just kept thinking, when would I do it?
Of course, as soon as we get our books sent to Amazon.
After the show, Jack. Oh, Carrie Ann says those would make awesome potato tacos. Never heard of that before.
Sorry, guys.
Sorry, I'm scrolling quickly through these. Oh, Janice says, next time I'm looking forward to you guys for roasted potatoes. Hope you do a video online.
I am going to do roasted potatoes, but it will probably be in January because we have so much Christmas and Thanksgiving. So I'm doing turkey on Wednesday, sweet potatoes casserole on Friday, And then there was something that somebody mentioned, and I thought, oh, I need to make that. Oh, shoot, what was it we were talking about at the beginning of the show? Somebody said, and I thought, oh, I need to make that for Thanksgiving. I'm going to make millionaire pie next week, which is so good. Pumpkin pie. And then what was the other thing I was going to do? And then I'm going to 2 weeks be, so either a week from Friday or the next beginning of the next week, I'm going to decorate our tree because I'm a florist and I know how to professionally decorate your Christmas tree.
Professionally.
Professionally.
Whoa.
It looks professional.
It does. That's why I don't do it. I let the professionals do it.
But we're doing it early, so you guys have time to share it, please.
Philosophy Phoenix says, do you add salt when you mix in the sugar?
I do, yes.
Oh, yeah, that's the idea.
I was trying to remember if you had answered that one already.
I've answered pretty much every single YouTube thing.
Did you tell about Sullivan Homesteaders? Sullivan Homesteader says, hi, everyone, making homemade BBC and salt and vinegar potato chips. Made potato cheese soup for dinner. That
Yum.
All sounds delicious.
Yeah, a bit of paprika would probably be good too, Jenny. Mm-hmm.
That does sound great. Just making sure we didn't miss any of these. I don't know which ones Dave already addressed.
What happened to the disaster soap?
Lynn, I love watching your vlogs. You're so entertaining and I don't have to watch political commercials. Thanks, guys.
Jamie,
yes,
you're welcome. We're
so,
glad to be here.
Now, off to this message. No, I'm kidding. Jamie, I have done nothing with the soap yet. You can see right here, half of the disaster soap is sitting waiting to be determined what I'm going to do with it.
Man, it smells really good.
I might try. Well, first of all, I'm going to peel off all the cherries and save the cherries. And I may try and rebatch it. Melt it down and make it hot process and see if I can save it somehow. Otherwise, it's going to be laundry soap.
I could put a string in it and hang it up on the mirror in my car.
And your car would smell really good.
It would smell really good. Mama Nachi asked, you might have answered this already. How much fragrance do you put in your soap? My husband makes soap and after it's cured, it doesn't have a smell. 1 ounce per pound? No. Okay.
Oh, you already answered that.
Janelle says the trees are gorgeous past peak now. Best time to come is mid-October. That's what I want to do.
I have never seen the trees changing back east, and that's like on my bucket list. I don't have a bucket list. That is my bucket list. To see the trees chaining.
Well, didn't we in Duluth that one time? That wasn't back east.
Yeah,
east.
But it wasn't at the peak.
I see.
It was, yes, it was at the end when we saw them in Duluth. But they were really pretty.
It was really pretty.
Yeah, they were really pretty.
1990 Farmhouse Home says, as I'm making loaded potato soup and homemade bread for tonight, hot rolls and cranberry yeast bread for breakfast.
Yum.
We need to come there. Philosophy Phoenix, everybody loved the cheeseburger rolls. My sons ate them for breakfast the next day. I wanted some for their lunch as well.
Damn!
I've been commenting a lot more on this, so if you see more comments.
Faye Frutos M9, you and your mom and family are just the blessing our family needed. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you for saying that.
Thank
and we're
you.
Glad to be here. Chris says, Dave, it's always nice to see your smile. Philosophy Phoenix. Sadly, I'm gluten-free, so I couldn't eat cheeseburger rolls.
Yeah, I can't either. I really, really miss them. I loved those.
No good way to make them. Ivany 119 says black garbage bag already packed for move.
Yeah.
let's see. Just checking to see what else we might have missed here. Philosophy Phoenix, you use a certain kind of potatoes.
I just use the regular russets is what I use for my potatoes.
Oh, and Ivany 119, leftover mashed potatoes is great for shepherd's pie.
Mm-hmm.
Yum. Let's take a quick look over here because there were some others we didn't quite get to. Carrie said for some reason the wooden spoon stops the water from boiling over. My sister-in-law showed me that trick and it works.
Yes, I was going to say that, and I've heard people swear by it, but I've never done it.
Oh, and somebody else said cream cheese, but Kareem says I put cream cheese and sour cream and butter and salt and pepper. That sounds
Yum.
Really good. and Michelle says warming the milk is a trick my mom used so there are no lumps.
Yeah.
Didn't know that. Let's see. Christine's praying for your turkey.
Thank you.
and Aisha said, the floor, you have to tell us.
Yeah, no, it was all over the floor. It was all over the floor.
And
we'll do a picture on Wednesday. We'll tell you more about it on Wednesday.
Yeah, her grandmother, the kid's great grandmother, was here, and she did a good job of holding
not
back
laughing
the laughter.
At me.
And Turid says 12:30 in the night in Norway. Last week I saw you at 11:30. Yes, Turid, sorry, but here in the United States they changed the time for daylight savings.
Yes.
So that's we're still at the same time. It's just that the time zone changed. So, let's see.
We're gonna skip a few.
Okay. You ready? I don't know if there's a lot.
You got all this from Robin, and then she got.
Shannon had said you can come to her house, but you'll have to cook for her.
I don't know if you want me to cook for you. I always have a disaster. Seems
oh,
like.
Hold on, Donna says butter and a little mayo is awesome in potatoes.
Oh yeah, that would be good.
Where's Robin's package?
And Stella says, "Come to my home, and it'll be just like eating at home for you because I'll be using your cookbook."
You got a present, Emily.
So.
I did.
Yes.
Whoops. Hopefully we didn't miss too much, but you're fading.
Yes, I'm fading. Hold on just a second.
I think we got most things.
So
you get two. So Robin sent them to us.
They're distracted by gifts.
So Emily's looking at her gift, Robin. She's so excited. She's so
thanks. Love you, girl. You're a true homie.
Nice.
You're a prankster, gangster.
There's nothing more fun than getting presents in the mail.
Let me know when you guys are done so I can make food.
Okay, we're done almost, so.
All right. Probably last comment. Janelle says she cooked her first turkey in a 13x9 cake pan covered with foil.
Oops.
That must have been messy.
Yes, that must have been really messy. All right, say goodbye to everybody.
Thanks,
bye.
Everyone, for joining us. Thanks,
please.
Dave the Dolphin Man.
Visit us at livingonadime.com. Don't forget our Dining on a Dime and Quick and Easy Menus is half price. And, of course, we always have Dining on a Dime. And we will see you guys Wednesday, and I'm making a turkey.
Yeah.
If I remember to turn it on in the morning for the show.
I'll remind you, probably, maybe, I don't know.
By the way, I am already defrosting the turkey for Wednesday's show. So, just so you know. All right, see you guys later.
Bye. Thanks, everyone.
Bye. Say bye.
Bye.
Let me go in the other. Hold on, guys.
Yes, man. Dave's getting this turned off.
I'm taking it down and...